Education as we know it is becoming obsolete. And I don't mean like a year-old smartphone. I mean like using 19th century tools to solve 21st century problems. Because it's exactly like that. After all, the way we educate our children has stayed pretty much the same since we even conceived of doing it. Listen to lectures, read and regurgitate, bubble in the answers, put a little hat on and call it a day. At this point, do we really think we're preparing them for the breathtaking ride that is the arc of human achievement and innovation in the 21st century? Probably not. And let me be clear, the problem is not teachers. Our teachers are doing an incredible job, all while working within an outdated, broken model. Renowned educator and philosopher John Dewey once said, "If we teach today's students as we taught yesterday's, we rob them of tomorrow." And that was in 1944. So great, we've established the problem. What's the solution? Burn the mother down. Start over from scratch. No, totally kidding. That's crazy. Here's the thing. There is no one right answer yet. But there are a lot of possible great answers. And those of us who are asking the question are absolutely thrilled with the possibilities. Let's take a trip to Alabama, to Jacksonville State University, where they've graduated more successful educators than any other university in their state. They are passionate and focused on transforming education from pre-K all the way to college. For example, they've developed a program called CORE that began as a collaboration between the university and visionary Piedmont City Schools. The concept here is to introduce new technologies and methodologies into high-need schools. But there's a lot more to it than just sticking an iPad in a kid's hands and inhaling it a groundbreaking new approach. After all, technology in classrooms is nothing new. Technology is just a tool that, when combined with a project and challenge-based learning approach, promotes 21st century critical thinking skills. So what does that mean? Essentially, it's just teaching kids to solve problems now, in the same way that we, as adults, solve them every day. And this idea of bringing education into the 21st century, it's like a little spark that found its fuel in the fertile minds of their entire educational community. And as it grew, so did their efforts, and so did their influence. Next thing you know, JSU has gotten the attention of the U.S. Department of Education, who, in turn, awarded them a $12 million grant that will help them study CORE for the next 5 years. Today, JSU is expanding its network to include new school districts and private sector partners to bring CORE to thousands and eventually hundreds of thousands of new students nationwide. Now, we know programs like CORE aren't going to change the world of education overnight. But what these programs and schools like JSU teach us is that there's hope. Hope that we can affect change from the inside out. That we can evolve. That a system on the verge of antiquity can still be saved. And that the best we have to offer our children truly can be our best. Thank you.